If you're an international medical graduate, you've probably heard of the pathways before. A pathway is an application portal for international medical graduates who want to apply for residency and work in the United States. What are pathways 3 to 5? Hello and welcome back to this channel. My name is Mark. Thank you for stopping by. The Educational Commission for Foreign Medical Graduates, otherwise known as the ECFMG, has made a decision in 2021 to allow international medical graduates who want to work in the United States to apply through pathways. Again, a pathway is an application process through which an applicant, an international medical graduate, can apply to work in the United States. The ECFMG is the only approved institution in the United States that evaluates international medical graduates' education. And with the cancellation of the United States Medical Licensing Exam Step 2CS, they needed to have a new way to assess the clinical skills of international medical graduates. Therefore, they came up with these 6 pathways. I have talked previously about pathway number 1 and pathway 2 in previous videos. I will put links in the description. The pathways were introduced in 2021 and 2022 and are going to be used for 2023, the upcoming match program. As of this time, the ECFMG has no indication that they're going to not use the pathways in the future. However, that is subject to change. Basically, there are 6 pathways that are available for international medical graduate. Today, we're going to look at pathways 3, 4, and 5. Pathway 3 is for any international medical graduate that has graduated from a program approved by the World Federation for Medical Education, the WFME. The link for the WFME will be in the description box below. This pathway is eligible for doctors who graduated on or after January 1st, 2021. If you graduated before 2021, this pathway does not apply to you. If you graduated before 2021, chances are you would have taken the USMLE Step 2CS clinical skills. If you do have your clinical skills examination results, you can apply without taking this pathway. Pathway 4 is for graduates from a country that has a comparable medical education system. This has been determined to be equal in educational value. This is determined by the National Committee on Foreign Medical Education and Accreditation, NCFMEA. This was established in 2008 as an act by the United States Congress with the Higher Education Opportunity Act. The link for these countries is also in the description below. The United Kingdom, Australia, and New Zealand are among those countries, as well as Ireland. Canada will go through the same accreditation system as the United States. Pathway 5 is for any IMG that has graduated from a dual accredited program. One of the programs must be in the United States and approved by the Liaison Committee on Medical Education, the LCME. As of this time, there are only 2 programs available, Duke University and the National University of Singapore, and the Weill Cornell Medical Qatar. For these pathways, there's another catch. Your school must attest to your clinical skills. They must give proof that your medical education meets a certain standard in clinical skills and clinical education, and that you can practice medicine as a doctor. This is something that your medical school must fill out if you're applying for pathways 3, 4, and 5. This is not something you can do on your own. This will be done through the clinical skills evaluation attestation portal. The requirements for the pathways are the same as for Pathway 1 and Pathway 2. You do need the United States Medical Licensing Exam Step 1 and Step 2 clinical knowledge. The same scores apply. You will also need the Occupational English Test Medicine with the same applicable scores of 300 in each of the 4 areas. The fee is also $925 for each program. There's also pathway 6, which I will talk about in a separate video, as that entails a little bit more of an explanation. Are these right for you? Well, if you are not eligible for number 1 or number 2, then number 3, 4, and 5 open them up for you. If your medical school is listed on the WFME, then that is great. You should be able to apply without any problem, provided that you get your attestation. I'm not sure what other countries are doing about medical certification for their schools. I know it's very stressful for current medical school students who are looking for the 2024 residency match. If their school is not certified by that time, certification does take time. Unfortunately, at this point, there is no easy answer for this. It will be a case-by-case, country-by-country decision. The ECFMG has put on their website that they're continuously trying to work with others on solutions. However, as of this time, I'm not sure what solutions for certain countries are. Again, I know it's very stressful. I have made several videos on the ECFMG requirement for 2024, as well as Pathway 1 and Pathway 2. You can check those out in the description box below. If there are any videos that you're interested in knowing about or topics, please let me know in the comment section below. I always appreciate it. Thank you very much for watching up to this point. I do offer lessons in communication skills, as well as interview practice. If you are going to go into the residency process, the application process, I do provide those kind of services, and the links will be in the description below. Thank you for watching. If you like this video, please consider giving it a thumbs up and subscribing. Until the next video, have a great one.